Praise the Lord. So, good evening po. So, sa gabi ito, we're going to study the Word of God. And let's pray. Let's pray before. Oh, let us read first our texts of this evening. Let's read it from the book of Titus, chapter 1, verse 1 to 5. Titus, chapter 1, verses 1 to 5. Let us read this all together. Ready? Read. Okay, wait. Are you there? Okay, so let us read it all together. Ready? Read. Paul, a servant of God and apostle of Jesus Christ, according to the faith of God's elect and the acknowledging of the truths which after godliness, in hope of eternal life, which God that cannot lie, promised before the world began. But he in the due times manifested his word through preaching, which is committed unto the according to commandment of God our Savior. To Titus, mine own son, after the common faith, grace, mercy, and peace from God the Father and the Lord Jesus Christ our Savior. For this cause left I thee in Crete, that thou shouldest set in order the things that are wanting, and obtain the elders in every city, as I have appointed thee. Let's pray. Dear Heavenly Father, once again, O God, we are so thankful, Lord. We are so, Lord, we are so thankful in our hearts, Lord, that once again we are going to study your word. And Lord, in our midst, be the one to be glorified. Bless thy word this evening, Lord. Holy Spirit, we recognize your presence, O God. We just pray for you to bless me, O God, as I preach your word. And bless thy people, O God. May this your word this evening be an encouragement to us, to all of us. And let the name of our Lord Jesus Christ be honored, O God, in our life. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Okay, so good evening po. So actually we have read our text from Titus chapter 1, verses 1 to 5. But I will be on verse 4. And verse 4 will be my springboard. Of my devotion or sermon this evening. It is about Titus. So here we can see that we will see how God used the life of Titus, and we can see how he served the Lord with all of his heart. So the title of my preaching this evening is The Joy of Serving Jesus with Others. The Joy of Serving Jesus with Others. So here we can see we will see in the sermon that how God used the life of Titus and how also Titus gave his life to the Lord and how he was used in the ministry of the Lord. So here in verse 4 says, to Titus, mine own son, after the common faith, grace, mercy, and peace from God the Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. So here we see that Titus is a Gentile convert. He is the Paul is the spiritual father of Titus. So he was left in the Crete. Most of the ministry of Titus was done in the island of Crete. Until his old age, he served the Lord in that island. He was able also to minister in Corinth and also in Dalmatia. So here we can see that serving the Lord is not easy. We know that, but it is a joy to serve the Lord. Amen. For us, we can see that a lot of people may misunderstood that serving the Lord is that, if you want to serve the Lord, you will just do this, just do it the way you want. No, there is something, or there is a price that we need to pay if we want to serve the Lord. And later on, we're going to see that. But in spite of all these things, as a Christian, as a believer of the Lord Jesus Christ, to serve the Lord is always a joy in our hearts. As a believer, as we have the Holy Spirit in our hearts, the joy is always there. If you're going to be, if you're aware of everything that is happening in our surroundings, sometimes there are difficult things that are happening in our life. Sometimes even in our needs, sometimes in our family, but the good thing about this, if you are a child of God, you will see the blessing of God and you will feel the peace of God that He gave to you. Even though things are getting difficult, But here we can see that serving the Lord is not that easy. Just like he said in Matthew chapter 16, verse 24. Matthew 16, 24 says, "Then said Jesus unto his disciples, If any man will come after me, let him deny himself, take up his cross, and then follow me." So that is what the Lord says, if you want to follow me. And in Matthew 10, 28 says, "And he that taketh not his cross and followeth after me is not worthy of me." If you will not carry your own cross, the Lord says, you will not carry this, how can you serve me? How can you show your love to me? So we can see that. But as the song said, there is joy in serving Jesus. It says here, there is joy in serving Jesus. As a journey on my way, joy that fills my heart with praises every hour and every day. I hope as a believer, I hope as a child of God, there is always joy in our hearts every hour and every day of our life. It may not be, sometimes we may not, it is, may not be noticeable because of the things that we are doing, but I do pray, and I hope and I pray that we will always see the goodness of serving the Lord in our life, every minute, every hour, every day, every week, every month, every year of our life. And this will be forever, even until eternity, we are going to feel the joy of the Lord, and we are going to serve Him with gladness. Paul served the Lord with hardship, but it is also a joy for him. We know the hardship of Paul, right? We know how he suffered for Christ. We know the marks of Christ. As in Galatia, he mentioned, even Pastor preached about that, that the mark that he has on his body because of serving the Lord Jesus Christ. For Paul, it says in Philippians chapter 1, verse 21, if you are going to analyze this, there is something in Paul that pushes him. It says in Philippians chapter 1, verse 21, "For to me to live is Christ, and to die is gain." He is a joyful servant of God, living for the Lord, and he is also a joyful servant, dying for the Lord. It is something that we can see from Paul. As Paul served the Lord, there are people who gladly serve with him. And one of them is Titus, and this will be my sermon this afternoon. So this evening, we're going to see the life of Titus, how he was used in the life of Paul, and how can he encourages us as a believer of the Lord Jesus Christ. So here we're going to study this. Titus, the meaning of Titus' name means nurse or helpful. Maybe that's why he's acting. Upon his name, the meaning of his name is nurse or helper. He is from Antioch, a Gentile convert by Paul. Most of his life serves the Lord in the island of Crete. And just like I mentioned, he also ministered in Corinth and in Dalmatia. Titus was a faithful servant of the Lord and a dedicated aide to Paul. He, even though Paul is an apostle, you will see how he was blessed by the life of Titus. For us here, may I encourage each and every one of us. Here we have a pastor, Pastor Joga. Sometimes we see him, he's doing all the job, he's preaching, doing all the ministry. But, you know, something that we can help him is to continue to encourage him by seeing in us, loving and serving the Lord. And through that, you will be encouraged and the church will be strengthened if you are doing the service for the Lord. Let me give some verses how the life of Titus became a big help to Apostle Paul. Let me give at least I have four verses here. It says in 2 Corinthians chapter 2, verse 13. Here we can see Paul found rest in Titus. Rest, what is that rest? We're going to see that. In 2 Corinthians chapter 2, verse 13 says, "I have no rest in my spirit, because I found not Titus my brother, but taking my leave of them, I went from thence into Macedonia." Here you can see in the word that mentioned by Paul, in verse 13 of 2 Corinthians chapter 2, he said, I had no rest in my spirit. The word rest here in Greek means anaposis. Anaposis means rest, from weariness. It's like from Matthew 11:28. Here, rest to, the rest means here to cause or permit one to cease from any movement and collect his strength. So here, it means to say that the life of Titus, it became an encouragement to Apostle Paul. And that's what we can see. And one of the meaning of the word rest in Greek is anesis. Or anesis means, you know what's the meaning of anesis? Relaxation. It's like something when Paul see the life of Titus, he's being relaxed. Let us read in 2 Thessalonians chapter 1, verse 7. 2 Thessalonians 1:7, it says here, and to you who are troubled, rest with us when the Lord Jesus shall be revealed from heaven with his mighty angel. So here we can see the word rest, and the word rest here is the word, the same with the word like relaxation. So here what I'm trying to say is this: Apostle Paul is being encouraged when he see the life of Titus. Later on we're going to see why. I will give you some more verses, but why Apostle Paul is being encouraged, though we know already the life of Apostle Paul. How he's being used by God, used mightily, how he gave his life to God. He forget, he denounced everything in his life when he was an unbeliever, and then he became a believer, he gave his life to the Lord. He gave his life fully to the Lord. But in all of this, we can still see how he was blessed by Titus, and how Titus gave his life to the Lord. In 2 Corinthians chapter 7, verse 6, here we can see Paul found comfort in Titus. Something like that we can, paano nangyari mga bagay na yun? In 2 Corinthians chapter 7, verse 6 says, nevertheless, God that comforted those that are cast down, comforted us by the coming of Titus. Here Paul was comforted by the actual coming of Titus from Corinth. And not only that, he is also comforted by the accomplishment that he did at Corinth. Here we can see the life of Titus that is being a comfort to the life of Apostle Paul. Why? Because here, by the eyes of Apostle Paul, Titus is doing the thing that God appointed him to do. And in all of those things that he is doing, Paul is being comforted. It's like something like this. Imagine Paul is comforted by the coming of Titus. There's no other interpretation or explanation on that. But when Paul see Titus, he was comforted. Seeing this brother doing the will of God in his life. For us, I believe that our pastor and even the leaders and even each and every one of us, I believe that we will be all joyful when we see each other doing the will of God in our life. And it will be a sad thing for us to see someone not doing the will of God. Seeing believers, they are pronouncing, they are saying they are believers, and yet they are not doing the will of God in their life. Yes, we may feel discouraged. Yes, we may feel weak sometimes, but the truth is that there is enough joy, there is enough peace in our heart because of the Lord for us to keep on keeping on for the Lord. And we know that the life of Titus here is used by God in the life of Paul. Though we know Paul is being used mightily in the ministry. But here is Paul says, he was comforted, especially in verse 7, says here, in verse 7, because of the positive response to Paul's letter carried by Titus, God's work being done through him in verse 7. Can you go there, please? And not by his coming only, but by the consolation wherewith he was comforted in you when he told us your earnest desire, your mourning, your fervent mind toward me, so that I rejoice the more. So here we can see how Titus doing the will of God, and Paul seeing Titus used by God. So may this be maging ano po sa atin to, maging encouragement po sa atin. And one thing that for me personally, as a believer, when I see a Christian joyfully serving the Lord, siyempre natutuwa ka. Of course, you are joyful. Pero one thing in the heart, especially our pastor, the leader, there will always sadness in our hearts when we see people saying they are Christian and yet they are not serving and they are disobeying the Lord. One of the saddest things that we can see. And you know, hindi nyo po kailangan maging pastor, hindi na kailangan maging leader, kahit nag-member ka, naglilinis ka lang ng mouth. When you see someone, a Christian, disobeying God and not doing the will of God in their life, malulungkot ka. You know that we were called to serve the Lord. It is not something, hindi ito sa palitan. We know, when we came to know the Lord Jesus Christ, there is a prompting in our hearts that because He first loved us, we loved Him. And because of that, we want to serve Him. And later on, we're going to see the things that happening in the life of Titus. Kung paano po siya lahat ng ito ginagawa. Alam niyo po, one thing that I want you to say here, Paul, I'm mentioning all of this in those, I have three more verses. Paul, I'm mentioning all the things that being done by Titus in the ministry. And yet, Titus doesn't know this. Yung iba, hindi niya alam. Para kumbaga, nagkukwento lang si Paul. Nagkukwento lang siya sa buhay ni Titus. And yet, he is being encouraged. In 2 Corinthians chapter 2, verse 8, chapter 8, verse 6, Paul, we can see here that Paul trusted Titus for the collection. I'm not showing you yung pong lahat ng bagay na naging ginagawa po ni Apostle Paul na kung saan ay nabibad ni Apostle ni Titus na nabibless po si Apostle Paul. So, in 2 Corinthians 8, verse 6, Paul trusted Titus for the collection. In so much that we desired Titus that as he had begun, so he would also finish in you the same grace. Also, here we can see, talks about the collection, the help to the church at Jerusalem. Ito po yung sa chapter 8 ng 2 Corinthians. But here, Paul trusted Titus. Kung meron pong isa sa Bible na kapag ka inaisip mo na hindi mapagkakatiwalaan sa pera, sino yan? Di ba si Judas? Si Judas. But here you can see the opposite way. Paul trusted this believer of the Lord Jesus Christ to get all of this. And not only that, alam niyo po bang that Titus was called a troubleshooter? He was a troubleshooter. Even in this problem of the collection is being used by God, para ayusin po ito. Do you know that even in the island of Crete, the people there are, they are liar, they are, what do you call this? They are disobeying, especially those things are being, the church are being, na-influensyahan. But do you know that Titus was used in the island of Crete to solve all this problem, and in throughout the life of Titus being a blessing in the life of Paul. So let us continue in verse 16 of chapter 8, 2 Corinthians. Here we can see that Paul and Titus had the same care. So here, kung paano po natin makita dun sa 2 Corinthians chapter 8, verse 6, that Paul trusted Titus, in verse 16 of chapter 8, Paul saying that they have the same care. Like saying, pag pinapunta ko dyan si Titus, kinulekta niya yung ano niya, yung mga dapat kuwanin, pagkatiwala niyo siya. Kasi parang ako na rin yan. I am not saying that they have the same totally. What I'm trying to say is this. As Paul loved to obey and serve the Lord, same as Titus. And Paul says, In verse 16, but thanks be to God which put the same earnest care into the heart of Titus for you. Sinabi niya po rito, same earnest care. Para nga umarin yan. Napumunta dyan. Pagkat walang later, later on, we're going to see that. In the following verse, I have one more verse. Makikita niyo doon. But here you can see, as Paul says, Titus will go there and collect the collection. But don't you worry. Kung napagkakatiwalaan niyo ako, same thing with that man. Hindi po ito isang magandang bagay para makita po sa atin bilang mga mananampalataya. Hindi lang po sa buhay ng mga kapag nasa church na tayo, or even in the church na wala po tayo sa loob ng church, or wala tayo sa vicinity, that we are doing the same thing for the glory of God. That we are doing all of this kasi mahal po natin ang Panginoon. He passes with the same earnest care. Ang sabi po na po, pareho kami yan. We have the same heart for the Lord. My question is this, do we have the same heart for the Lord? Sometimes we are being discouraged, alam ko po yan. No, all of us, we know that. But do we have the same heart to continue to serve the Lord with faithfulness? We are not always faithful all the time. We are not perfect. But bilang sa pamananampalataya, there will always, there should be a faithfulness serving the Lord. Kagaya po ng sinashare nga po ni Brother Jung about the gym. Siguro kung magkakasalaman tayo, it is not because we wanted to. We don't do sin and we don't do mistake. We commit sin, we commit mistake. Yun po tayo. But as a faithful servant of God, we should always be on that way, or on that path. Bilang mga mananampalataya, we may not be able to do it with ourselves. No one can do that. But we can always pray to God to help us to accomplish the things that He wants us to do in our life. So here we can see the life of Titus. Paano niya po nagagawa mga bagay na ito? Actually, when he's doing this, let me just say it this way. Alam niyo, yung ginagawa niya po ito, para sa kanya yung he's just enjoying serving the Lord. Wala po siyang ini-expect na recognition. Wala po siyang ini-expect na papuri. He's just enjoying the Lord. Serving Him. Yan ay open, ay pray tayo po lahat. Yung para bang pag kumakain ka, di ba, mahilig tayong kumain. Nag-i-enjoy ka sa pagkain. Wala kang pakialam sa paligid mo kapag ini-enjoy mo yung pagkain. And I hope and I pray, same thing when we are serving the Lord. Na hindi mo tayo magsiserve kasi hindi ako kinamayan ni Pastor. Ang bihira naman. Hindi ako tinapik ni Pastor. Tatampo na. I hope makita po natin yung ginagawa natin. It is because we love the Lord. It is not because we are showing someone or we are showing something to anyone para magsabihin nila pinaglilingkuran natin ang Panginoon. No. It doesn't work that way. If we want to glorify God in our life, we need to give our life. Sabi niya, if you will not carry this cross, how can you obey me? How can you serve me? That's what the Lord says. Pero tayo, bilang mananampalataya, we should serve the Lord faithfully. And here in my last verse, you can see in 2 Corinthians chapter 8, verse 23. 2 Corinthians 8, 23. Paul's fellow worker bringing the glory to Christ. First fellow worker bringing the glory of Christ. Whether any do inquire of Titus, he is my partner and fellow helper concerning you. Or brethren be inquired of, they are the messengers of the churches and the glory of Christ. If you're going to look at the verse, he says here, whether any do inquire of Titus, kung meron magtatanong kay Titus, Paul says, he's my partner. Imagine that. Paul saying that, he's my partner. Kung meron kang problema sa kanya, ako tanongin nyo. That's what Paul is saying. He's my fellow helper concerning you. Talking to the Corinthians, our brethren be inquired of, they are the messengers. They are the messengers of the churches, and this, look at this thing, and it possesses, and the glory of Christ. Kung titingnan po natin, alam niyo ang sabi ni Paul, at this is what Paul is saying. Titus is the glory of God in serving Him. Sabi ni Paul, tingnan niyo ang buhay ni Titus. God is being glorified in his life. That's what Paul is saying. God is being honored in the life of Titus. Here, we can see the highest recognition. Pero hindi naman ito nasa, but Titus did not, ano to, hindi niya po ito hiningi. The one who said that is Paul. But because of his life, using for the work of the Lord, Paul seeing Titus bringing the glory of Christ in his life. Alin po tayo po bilang mama na nagpapa? Sometimes, sabi nga sa inyo, marami po tayong nararanas, but do you know that you are bringing the glory of Christ in you? Minsan, nag-discourage po tayo. Sometimes, we are being weakened because of many things that we are facing. But do you know that bilang isang mama na nagpapa, do you know that we are already perfect in the sight of God? We are sitting in the heavens with the Lord Jesus Christ. And you know that tayo po kasi, this is how we look. We look on the judgment of people and we are not concerning or we are not, hindi natin tinitingnan how God judges us. Yes, in the sight of people, marami tayo nagagawa and they will never be satisfied. But look at Paul, saying that the life of Titus is the glory of Christ. And that's who we are. Ikaw yun, ako yun. Kasi anak po tayo ng Diyos. Well, if you are not a child of God, you don't have the glory of God in you. Kasi you are not a child of God. But if you are a child of God, you have Christ in you, the hope of glory. And that is the thing that gives us encouragement in our life. The greatest of all commendation is to be characterized as bringing glory to Christ. Wala na pong hihigil pa doon. Bringing the glory of Christ in our lives. How can I say this? Alam niyo, tayo po in the eyes of man, we are people who not being judged because of what we do, because they don't understand. We are being judged because we are doing these things for the Lord and they don't understand. But you know what? Christ is seeing us, or the Father is seeing us, bringing the glory to honor God in our life. And I hope this thing will give us encouragement in our life. And I hope makita po natin yung katapatan ng Diyos sa buhay natin. I hope makita po natin the way God sees us. Even the way we see other people or the way we see ourselves. Because in the eyes of God, we are already perfect. At least doon masasabi na natin, we are perfect because of the Lord. Lastly, see the life of Titus doing the work of the Lord. As we walk with the Lord, we are becoming like Him. Alam niyo po, as we continue to serve the Lord, hindi mo sinasabi yung kamukha po natin sa yung literal, no? The character of the Lord is being seen in us. And one more thing, kung pag-aaralan po natin, and we're going to notice this, the life of Titus, hindi po niya lang na yung buhay na ipinamumuhay niya that time ay yung buhay po niya ay pinamumuhay ang buhay ng Panginoong Yesus. So I hope and I pray to po maging encouragement po sa atin, and I hope and I pray that whenever the time that we see we are being bombarded by problems, that's all we see, that Christ is being honored in us, especially when we do His will in our life. I pray my line. Heavenly Father, we thank you, Lord, for this evening.